Welcome to the next eAcademy episode. Today we will discuss issues related to the ABAX 2 two-way wireless system. We will present the method of registering the ABAX 2 radio devices to the ACU220 controller working as a universal module of wireless devices. We will also show you how to use the operating mode in the AXD200 universal detector. Okay, what do we need for that? A computer with Windows operating system and the ABAX 2 soft program. An ACU220 controller with backup power supply and battery. An APD200 motion detector. An AXD200 universal detector. An ASP215 indoor siren. An APT200 key fob. And a USB RS converter. First, the operating mode of the AC220 module must be selected. For this purpose, use the DIP switches 9 and 10 located on the electronics board. By setting them in the right way, you can indicate whether ACU220 is to work as a wireless device expander for the Intriga, Intriga Plus, or Versa control panels, or whether it should work in the universal wireless module mode. For the purposes of today's episode, let's choose the last option. The other switches have a different purpose. The number 8 is used to select the transmitting antenna. The point is that the polarization of the ACU module antenna should be the same as that of the antenna in the other devices operating in the system. The quality of the radio signal depends on it. The switches with numbers from 1 to 5 should be used to set the ACU module address for work with the Intriga, Intriga Plus, or Versa control panel series. Now the controller power supply can be turned on. Connect the USB RS converter to the computer, and then to the RS232 TTL connector on the controller. Run the ABAX 2 soft program. In the right part, click on the symbol of additional menu. Select configuration. Indicate the RS232 port to which the USB RS converter is connected and click OK. Find the connect/disconnect icon. Clicking the icon will establish connection to the ACU220 module. In the upper part of the window, you can read the module type, serial number, and firmware version. To check if any devices are registered or settings are saved to the controller, click the Read Data button. View the Devices and Key Fobs tab. Our module has started for the first time, so you can see all the fields are blank. Let's go back to configuration. In this tab, you can set the communication period, which is the time interval at which wireless devices are to communicate with the controller. You can choose an interval of 12, 24, or 36 seconds. During periodic communication, wireless devices send information about their status to the controller, for example about violations, battery status, etc. In response, various commands are sent to the devices, for example, relating to the changing sensitivity settings or operating mode of the detectors. Exactly, the detectors can work in two modes, passive and active. The passive mode means that the detector periodically sends information to the controller, whereas in the active mode, information is also sent after each violation so as to avoid unnecessary delay. Important note: information on such events as tamper or active detector violation are sent to the controller immediately, regardless of the communication period setting. It should be noted that the less frequently periodic transmissions take place, the lower energy consumption will be. In battery-powered devices, this translates into a longer operating time without battery replacement. Let's go back to the ABAX 2 soft program. In the configuration window, you can assign NO or NC type to individual zones and outputs of the ACU220 module. The choice depends on what you will use the controller for, whether it is to work, for example, with any alarm control panel, or in the standalone mode, for example, as a wireless gate controller. As for the outputs, you can also specify their operation time in the table. When controlled with a key fob, they behave as a mono switch and are turned on for the specific time. If zeros only are left there, the output will behave like a bistable switch when controlled with a key fob. Under the tables, there is a No Automatic Wireless Device Firmware Update checkbox. By selecting this option, the firmware of wireless devices enrolled into the controller will not be updated automatically. Now let's go to the Devices tab. The ACU220 controller can support up to 48 wireless devices. As the first one, we will register the APD200 motion detector. To do this, open the detector enclosure by gently turning the lock. Remove the front part of the enclosure. Push down the electronics module to disconnect it. then carefully remove it from the enclosure. At the back of the module, there is a sticker with the detector serial number. In the program, click on the plus button. In the open window, enter the serial number of the detector to be added. Information appears that the tamper switch must be violated. Insert the battery instead. The device has been loaded. You can still choose its number and click OK. As you can see, the APD-200 detector has appeared on the list. Put the detector electronics module back into the enclosure. Lock it into position, carefully replace the front part of the enclosure. Press it until you hear a characteristic click. The detector is ready for operation. The next device to be registered to the controller will be the AXD-200 Universal Detector. However, first you must choose what role it will play in your system. In the previous episode, we said that the AXD-200 detector can work in one of seven modes. Now I will show you how to choose the detector type. The first step is to open the detector enclosure and install the battery. The LED will blink rapidly. You have about 10 seconds to activate the detector selection mode. To turn it on, tap the enclosure 3 times. Now count how many times the LED will flash. Once, this means a magnetic contact. If you do not tap the enclosure again, this type will be remembered after 10 seconds. To make a change, tap on the enclosure once. 2 flashes, 2 channel magnetic contact. Tap again. 3 flashes, magnetic contact with roller shutter input. Another tap. The LED has flashed 4 times, which means shock detector and magnetic contact. Tap. 5 flashes, reorientation detector. 6 flashes, temperature detector. Tap again to go to the last mode. The LED flashes 7 times, water flood detector. The next tap will bring you back to the first mode. Okay, a single flash, so magnetic contact mode. For the last selected mode to be remembered, you must wait about 10 seconds. A single flash of the LED has confirmed the detector is programmed as magnetic contact. Subsequent taps on the enclosure will not change the detector settings anymore. To change the detector type again, you would have to remove the battery and repeat the entire process. To register the AXD-200, click the plus button. Enter the detector serial number. Violate the tamper switch. You can see that the detector has been loaded. Its type corresponds to our presets. The detector connects the AMD-200 magnetic contact. Choose a number for it and click OK. You can already see the detector on the list. Depending on the selected operation mode, it could occupy more than one position. For example, when working as AMD-202, that is, a magnetic detector with roller shutter input, it would occupy 2 positions. Another device to be registered to the controller will be the ASP-215 Indoor Acoustic Optical Siren. Click the plus button. Open the device enclosure. Find the serial number and enter it in the program. Violate the tamper switch or insert battery in the siren battery compartment. Device data has been loaded. We can close the enclosure. The ASP-215 takes up 2 positions. Therefore, the program prompts us to use 2 of the available numbers. Click OK. The siren has appeared on the list. It occupies 2 rows in the table. After registering the devices, click on the Send Data button. Let's go to the Status tab. After a while, you can see that the information about tamper memory, power supply voltage, firmware version of registered wireless devices has appeared in the table cells. Further details of the status of individual devices will be discussed next time. The last device that we will register to the ACU220 today will be the APT200 Key Fob. Let's go to the Key Fobs tab. Press the plus button. To find the serial number of the Key Fob, you must open its enclosure. Enter the number in the program. According to the displayed information, press any button. Device data has been loaded. The ACU220 controller working in the universal mode can handle up to 256 key fobs. Hence, you can choose any number between 1 and 256. Click OK. The key fob information has appeared in the table. Save the data to the memory module. Finally, let's open the Key Fob State tab. Although you can see the device on the list, the information about battery voltage, firmware version, etc. is still missing there. All you have to do is press any button on the key fob for the respective cells of the table to be populated with the key fob data. Okay, the information that interests us is now there. That's all for today's episode. Thank you. We invite you to watch the next episodes of the E-Academy. See you soon.